Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Nice to see you back. And one of my subscribers is requesting me from ages that please tell me the secret to happy relationships, how to be happy in relationships, how to be happy within a relationship or a marriage or a friendship or as a father or as a son or as a wife or as a husband or whoever you are. So today we will discuss some sutras, some secrets which everybody knows, but still many people have forgotten this. So if you're new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation regarding your love life or your marriage or your career or your health or any other issue which is bogging you in your life currently, then you can please go to my website. You will find the link of the website in the description of this video down below. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So now, how do we have happy relationships? And this is for anybody. Suppose you are with a friend or with your boyfriend or your girlfriend or your husband or your wife. This can be applied anywhere. So always remember that the person who is with you, whoever the person is, the person's responsibility is only to share your happiness. Should I repeat? The person's only responsibility is to share your happiness and to share his or her happiness with you. The person's duty is not to give you happiness. That is your own job. So instead of liking photos in Facebook, like, be with someone who makes you happy. Instead, you should be someone who makes you happy. Should I repeat? Instead of being with someone who makes you happy, you should become someone who makes you happy. Which means you should not wait for somebody else to come and transform your life. See, there is no joker in this world who will do it. The opposite sex may do it for some point of time, but that will only be there initially. That will never happen every day. At least I don't know of anybody who does that. So basically the point is, we have to take charge of our own lives and we have to do those activities which give us happiness in life, rather than sitting and watching TV, football, or unnecessarily browsing things in YouTube. If we keep doing these things, then we are not in line with our original purpose. Then what happens is, we are internally not happy. We are internally not satisfied. And then we cannot share our happiness. Then people say, oh, our relationship is very boring. There's nothing in our relationship. Everything is exhausted. We do not get butterflies when we see each other anymore. No? We do not get goosebumps. We do not feel like jumping when we see each other. Why? Well, that's happening because of the hormones initially, but that will not happen every day. So on a long run, you have to identify those activities which give you happiness. For example, it can be anything. You have to understand who you are basically, and you have to keep doing those things every day, each and every day, day in, day out. You have to do those activities. Very simple exercise you can do. Every day, spend 15 minutes doing what you like. Very simple this is. There's no complication here. Anybody can understand. Suppose you like to sing, then spend singing for every day 15 minutes. Suppose you like to paint, spend time painting for 15 minutes. You don't have to paint for 2 hours. 15 minutes is enough. You can paint for more also. You can, and you can send me the photos in WhatsApp also to me. My number is there below. If you like to go outside and travel and click photos, that you can do, and that also you can do it maybe once in a week. If that is what makes you happy, do it. You have to become a whole within yourself. Whole means you understand. You have to be happy without the other person. Only then you will be happy with the other person. Should I repeat? Only if you are happy without somebody, you can be happy with that person. Otherwise, these things keep happening. I keep getting stories of people who tell me that, oh, my partner is messaging me day in and out. I'm getting bored. I feel choked. My partner is very desperate. Why these things are happening? Because that person is expecting you to come and give them happiness. That cannot happen. It can't happen. It has never happened, and it cannot happen, and it will never happen. That is why these days there are so many breakups. Every third marriage in USA ends up in a divorce. Some say every second marriage, some say every fourth marriage, but this is the average situation. It's very precarious these days. Why? Because everybody is sitting and thinking, oh, one day there will be some, there's a La La Land, you know, like it's there in Harry Potter or Alice in Wonderland, where there will be a prince who will come and he will entertain us for the rest of our lives. That's going to happen, right? No, you are simply going to sit and do things together. That is all you are going to do. You will clean the toilets together. You will clean the kitchen together. You will clean the bathroom together. You will clean your daily room together. That is all you are going to do. Nothing else. Nothing more than that. So stop fantasizing about your ideal dream partner who is going to come and change your life totally. And if you want to know who that person is, go and see in front of the mirror. You will find that person. So that person is you. You have the power to change yourselves. Nobody else has the power. And that's the best part, you see. Because you know best what you want. You know best what can make you happy. You know best what will give you fulfillment. That is something which you know very much. And when you keep doing that, then you will automatically attract other people who are also in that frequency. So if you are having knowledge of astrology or spirituality, then you will also attract a person who is also like that. And if you are a totally mundane, materialistic person, then you will also attract another person who is like that. So if you are happy with your own life, with your dreams, with your goals, with your purpose, then you can also give happiness to others. Because you cannot give happiness unless you are happy. Should I repeat? You cannot give happiness unless you are happy. That's the point, you see. So to give happiness, you have to be happy first of all. And to be happy, that is your responsibility. That is nobody else's responsibility. Nobody in the universe is having the duty of making you happy other than you yourself. So when you take charge of your own life, only then you will be happy. And you have to do those activities every day in and day out. As I said, 15 minutes every day you can spend. Just do this one thing and check. Your life will change like this. And nowadays there's so many things. You can do something in YouTube. You can, if you are like singing, you can sing and open a channel. You can start a new channel. One of my subscribers have done that, I know. His name is Saurav Bilwalkar, I think. Maybe he sees this video someday. So he has opened a channel. He does all this singing and all these things, editing. So that is kind of something which he likes very much. So he has opened a channel and he's doing all these things. So he's very happy, I guess. At least when he's doing that, may not be throughout the day, but when he's doing that, at least he's very happy. So he should keep doing this, and one day maybe he gets 100,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, And when we inculcate spiritual practices in our life, in our daily life, then these things become much more easier. Because then you are more in tune with your own self. Then you can understand yourself more better when you are in Sattva Guna. When you are not in Sattva Guna, when you are in Rajas Guna or Tamas Guna, then it becomes very difficult. You talk to any person who is in the mode of Rajas. Now, what you want to do in life, he will say 10 things. I want to become a doctor, I want to become a singer, I want to become a musician, I want to become a scientist, I want to become an astrologer, everything he wants to become. He wants to become everybody else other than who he actually wants. And he has so many suggestions for everybody, you see. Oh, you should become this, you should become that. And what should you become? Oh, that I don't know. I will go to an astrologer and get a career reading, right? Or I will go to a consultant or a coach or a psychiatrist. That person will help me. Yes, these people can help you, there's no doubt, but ultimately the gun is on your hand. You have to fire the bullet. nobody will fire it for you. An astrologer or a life coach or a guide can tell you 10 directions where to go, but ultimately it is you to decide among those directions where will I end up going finally, and where you decide, there you land. So how to inculcate spiritual practices? We should do our daily meditation in the morning if it is possible, or if it is not possible, we should make it possible. We should chant at least one or two rounds of the mantras which we chant in the morning. We should do it without fail every day. And every day morning we should read minimum 10 to 15 minutes these scriptures, like Bhagavad Gita, like Srimad Bhagavatam, these scriptures when we read. And then throughout the day when we are going outside, we should keep hearing audio, spiritual bhajans, these things we should keep hearing. Then our mind is calm, our mind is peaceful, we can do things in a focused way. And then we become happy internally, and then we can also give happiness to somebody who is with us. We can share our happiness with them, and by that we will see that our relationships have become very beautiful. Otherwise you will be like that, oh, maybe today we should go to the movie, tomorrow to a Hollywood movie, then day after tomorrow to a Bollywood movie. You will keep hopping like this from one place to the other place, and then you will start hopping over other people also. It doesn't work like this. Okay, so whenever you think that, whenever you get a signal that you are not happy within relationships, just think of one thing. Suppose tomorrow this person disappears from my life, who I am complaining that I am not happy with, what will happen to me? Do I have certain things which I can do without this person? If you get a question mark or a no or a maybe, or if not, maybe, but, if these kind of words are popping in your head when you are thinking of this, it's a red signal. So then what you should do? You should back off. Back off doesn't mean you break up, but you should say to your partner that I need some time off for myself. Not that I will not talk to you or invest in the relationship, but I want to be more focused in myself because I want to make myself happy first. Because without that, I cannot give you happiness, you see. Imagine a person who is only crying, criticizing, complaining. How disgusting it is to stay with that person. Imagine your life partner is like that. The only thing you do when you come back from office, suppose you are a man and your wife is a housewife, for example. So whole day maybe she's watching TV serials, and then she's gossiping and bitching about other ladies, what they are doing. And the moment you come home, she starts, oh, you know, this lady did this. Or suppose she's working in a corporate company like today. And then there, when she's going, instead of working, she's focused on who is having an affair with whom, who got the promotion, how. And then when she comes home, she keeps telling all these things to you. Oh, you know, this guy got promotion like this. This man did this. Oh. So you will be the most frustrated husband to have ever lived. And so most of the husbands, their situation is like this. Most of the wives, their situation is like this. What to speak of men or women? Both are the same in this category. Situation is precarious. And I am not saying this from my experience. I have been single my whole life. I don't know how it is to be in a relationship, but this is what other people tell me from from their experience. I am telling you. So this is not my own story. This is the story of everybody else. So many people, they message me, oh, my partner has made my life hell. And I'm like, why are you staying with them? Get out of the relationship. No, don't get out. Stay and improve the relationship. Okay. So there you go. Inculcate spiritual practices in your life and have a goal, have a focus in life. Become happy yourself. And then by that, you will also be able to give happiness to others, and then your relationship will be much better. Okay, whichever relationship it is, your partner or your parents or your children, whoever they are, your friends, acquaintances, people with your neighbors, your colleagues, your boss, your subordinates, everybody. It is for everybody actually, because nobody likes to sit with a person who is unhappy, because they say the happy person is most attractive. Okay. So if you want to be more and more attractive, you cannot control how much beautiful you are. That is there by God's plan. That is there in your destiny. You cannot control it beyond a certain level. How beautiful you look. You can apply makeup, of course, but still you can't exceed beyond a level. But you can definitely become more attractive, you see, by becoming more happy, because everybody wants to stay with a happy person. Okay, so there you go. If you are new to the channel and if you want a consultation, then please go to my website, and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it and share this video with somebody who is interested to know how to have happy relationships. Okay, until next time, wish you good luck. Bye bye. See you.